Are you realizing that you need to start using video to grow your rapport with the new network that you're building, but you're wondering what the heck kind of equipment do you need as a beginner to get started? If so, you're in the perfect place. I'm Adrienne with Build a Life by Design, and today I'm gonna walk you through the basic, and I mean basic, equipment someone needs to get started. Because in all honesty, I was looking through YouTube myself to try to find a listing of equipment, see what other people were recommending, and they were like way out there with like crazy DSLR cameras, lighting equipment that looked like a professional photographer used it. And honestly, you guys, you don't need that crazy stuff. In this video, I'm going to take you through just the basics. If that's all you're looking for, then you're in the perfect place. The two things, and honestly, there's only two things that you need to make a decent video for a beginner. People need to be able to clearly see you, and people need to be able to clearly hear you. That's about it. But in order to make that work, you're going to want some sort of a ring light, whether it's a floor standing ring light or whether it's a desk mount ring light. You want something that can both hold your phone, so you can just record from a regular phone, no need to get fancy, guys, but something to hold your phone and light your face. Because if people can't see you, if your hand is wiggling, you're trying to hold it with your hand, or the lighting is terrible, it's gonna be really hard for people to focus on what you're saying. So at a minimum, I recommend a ring light. In the comments below, I will attach links to both a floor standing ring light as well as a kind of a desk mount version so that you can pick whichever one works for you depending on where you're filming. That will help to make sure that people can very clearly see you and focus on what you're saying. Now, for those of you who are wondering, like, is this overkill? Do I really need a ring light? You know, I have a well-lit room. I'm gonna give you a little demo here. I'm in my home office. It has good lighting, good ceiling lighting, as well as a natural light window that's over here. And even then, without the ring light, it's dim. It's kind of hard to see me without a ring light, and I don't feel as confident without the ring light. And I think this is gonna be a common thing that you'll see too. So let me show you what happens when I turn the ring light off. Can you still see me? Kind of. Can you see me as well? Not really. There's tons of shadow going on. There's like kind of some light coming in from the windows over there. It's dim. It's not as engaging, right? Definitely not. Versus when the light is on, you can very clearly see me. You can see my face. You can see me speaking. You can see my hand gestures. I'm very well lit. My skin looks better. My teeth look whiter. I feel more confident. And let's be honest, you guys, if you feel more confident in front of the camera, you're more likely to film the video. If fear is in any way holding you back, trust me, a ring light is awesome. Plus it makes it, you know, it's hands-free. If you're a hand talker like me, you're gonna appreciate it. So trust me, a ring light is definitely in order. That just brings us to the second thing you're going to need, which is good audio. Because let's be honest, even if you look great, if no one can hear you, they're gonna tune out, okay? People need to be able to hear you. And again, I know there's gonna be some of you thinking like, that seems like overkill. Do I really need a fancy mic? And the answer is no, you don't need a fancy mic. But yes, you probably do need a basic mic. And that's because, again, if people can't hear you, they're just gonna tune out. It does not have to be crazy. Both of the versions I use were like 20 bucks. I have a desk mount version, and then I have a lapel version. The desk mount version I actually attach to my ring light stand with a simple piece of Velcro. Nothing that I use is high tech, and nothing you use has to be high tech either. So I will attach links to both of those microphones below and some of the adapter cords that I need to make them work with my iPhone in case you're one of those people. Super basic visuals, super basic audio. That's really all you need. Now, for those of you who might want to be filming when you're walking or you're on the go or you're on vacation somewhere and there's a really cool background behind you, I will also include a link to like an expandable kind of holdable stand. Okay, I'll actually show you mine. All right, so there's this guy. It has a little stand at the bottom. If you want it to be desk mount, it simply holds your phone here. Nothing crazy, you guys, just the basics. So here's another option that I'll throw into the comments below. And then for those of you who are thinking, I don't have a super cute background, I don't have a home office, I don't have a place that's good for filming, I have like kids stuff everywhere, or my house is a disaster, don't worry, you guys. You don't need a pretty or special or fancy background. You just need to make sure that it's not completely distracting or disastrous. So if your house is a disaster, yeah, don't film that with your background. But all you need is a basic, clean background. So I do happen to have a really nice home office, but I'm not the best at keeping my desk clean, so there's almost always junk all over it. I choose to just film in front of a plain background and to keep it simple. And honestly, you guys, you can get these off of Amazon. They're super cheap. I don't have a fancy mounting system by any means. I simply bought this off of Amazon and I mounted it with command strips on my wall. Like, that's it. It's super simple. You can keep this simple, you guys. I will attach some links to that as well. Video can be super huge in building rapport with your network and building that know, like, and trust factor so people can, you know, focus on what you're teaching them, what you're showing them, what they see you doing. And it makes them more likely to want to ask you questions about your products, your services. You know, they'll start to view you as more of the authority figure on these things. So of course, that's always good to be viewed as an authority in whatever it is that you're promoting or selling, right? Video is super important for building those trust factors, and it doesn't take a lot. It just takes a little bit, and you can totally do it too. I'm Adrienne with Build a Life by Design, and I help people to build six-figure income from home by building passive income. They can have true freedom in their lives. That sounds like something you're interested in doing. Subscribe so that I can help you to do that. You can either subscribe below in the links, or you can hit this logo that's floating over here, or you can just stay tuned for the next video that'll show up over here. And I'll see you guys next time around.